We have already seen the generation of SSBSC modulated signal by using filter method and phasing method. In this lecture, we will see the generation of the SSBSC modulating signal by using Weber's method, which is also known as third method. This method is another form or variant of phasing method, which we have discussed earlier in the previous lecture. This method was invented by Dr. D.K. Weber in 1950. It avoids the need for wideband phase shifters, which are difficult to construct and expensive, and instead uses an AF subcarrier at an audio frequency for the generation of the SSBSC modulated signal. This method has the advantage of phase shift method, such as availability to generate SSBSC at any frequency. It uses low audio frequencies without the associated disadvantage of an audio frequency phase shift network required to operate over a large range of audio frequencies. This is the block diagram for the SSBSC modulated signal with the help of Weber's method. This block diagram is consists of 4 balanced modulator, 2 low pass filter, 2 90 degree phase shifter and a summer block. In this method, only the carrier signal is shifted by 90 degree rather than both carrier and message signal in the case of phasing method. So the circuit complexity reduces drastically. Here we will use 2 different types of carrier signal generator, and the difference between these 2 carrier signal generator is that one generates audio frequency carrier signal and another generates radio frequency carrier signal. And the radio frequency carrier signal will have a greater frequency than the audio frequency carrier signal. At first, 2 identical message signal MT are given as the input to the balanced modulator 1 and 2. Then audio frequency carrier signal C1T and the 90 degree phase shifted audio frequency carrier signal C1'T are given as the 2 input to the balanced modulator 1 and 2 respectively. With 2 inputs of message signal and the carrier signal, balanced modulator 1 and 2 generates the signal X1T and X2T. Both of the generated signals are given as the input to the low pass filter. This low pass filter, having the cutoff frequency FM-F0, only allows low frequency term to pass through, eliminates the high frequency term, and finally the output signals from this low pass filter are termed as Y1T and Y2T. Now the 2 signals from the low pass filter are given as the input to the balanced modulator 3 and 4, and the radio frequency carrier signals C2T and the 90 degree shifted radio frequency carrier signal or C2'T are given as 2 input to the balanced modulator 3 and 4 respectively. With the 2 inputs of message signal and the carrier signal, balanced modulator 3 and 4 generate the signals V1T and V2T. These 2 output signals are given as 2 inputs to the adder, where the addition of the 2 outputs from the balanced modulator 3 and 4 will give the upper sideband SSBSC modulated signal, and the subtraction of the 2 outputs from the balanced modulator 3 and 4 will give the lower sideband SSBSC modulated signal. Let's see the mathematical analysis for the Weber's method of SSBSC generation. For the balanced modulator 1, let's say message signal MT is equal to sine 2 pi FMT, and audio frequency carrier signal C1T is equal to cos 2 pi F0T. The frequency of the message signal FM is greater than the frequency of the carrier signal, or FM will be greater than F0. Then the output of the balanced modulator 1 or X1T is equal to MT into C1T. If we replace the value of MT as sin 2 pi FMT and C1T as cos 2 pi F0T, then X1T can be written as X1T is equal to sin 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi F0T. Now, we will divide and multiply the equation of x1t by 2, then the equation will become x1t is equal to half into 2 sin 2 pi fmt into cos 2 pi f0t. Now, we can apply 2 sin a cos b formula, which is equal to sin a plus b plus sin a minus b in the following equation. Then, the equation of the output of the balanced modulator 1 or x1t can be given by x1t is equal to half into sin 2 pi fm plus f0 into t plus sin 2 pi fm minus f0 into t. The equation of x1t can be simplified as x1t is equal to half into sin twice pi fm plus f0 into t plus half into sin twice pi fm minus f0 into t. Now, this signal will be given as the input to the low pass filter, and low pass filter will allow low frequency term or half into sin 2 pi fm minus f0 into t. So, after passing through the low pass filter, output y1t is equal to half into sin 2 pi fm minus f0 into t. Now, this signal is given as the input to the balanced modulator 3 along with the radio frequency carrier signal or C2T. So, the inputs to the balanced modulator 3 is Y1T is equal to half into sin 2 pi FM minus F0 into T and carrier signal cos 2 pi FCT. Now, the output of the balanced modulator 3 will be multiplication of these 2 inputs, or V1T is equal to half into sin 2 pi FM minus F0 into T into cos 2 pi FCT. Now we will divide and multiply this equation by 2, then V1 t will become 1 by 4 into 2 sine 2 pi fm minus f0 into t into cos 2 pi fc t, where we can again apply the formula of 2 sine b cos a is equal to sine a plus b minus sine a minus b. Here, as the carrier frequency fc is greater than fm minus f0, if we apply this formula in the following equation, then equation of v1t can be written as v1t is equal to 1 by 4 sine twice pi fc plus fm minus f0 into t minus sine twice pi fc minus fm plus f0 into t, which can be simplified as v1t is equal to 1 by 4 sine twice pi fc minus f0 plus fm into t minus sine twice pi fc plus f0 minus fm into t. Now, for the balance modulator 2, message signal mt is equal to sine 2 pi fm t and the audio frequency carrier signal or c1 prime t is equal to sine 2 pi f0 t. The output of this balance modulator 2 will be the multiplication of this 2 signal or x2 t is equal to sine 2 pi fm t into sine 2 pi f0 t. Now, we will divide and multiply this equation by 2, then the equation will become x2 t is equal to half into 2 into sine 2 pi fm t into sine 2 pi f0 t. Now, we can apply the formula of 2 sine a sine b, which is equal to cos a minus b minus cos a plus b, or x2 t is equal to half into cos 2 pi fm minus f0 into t minus cos 2 pi fm plus f0 into t. If we simplify the equation by multiplying half with both the terms, x2 t can be written as x2 t is equal to half into cos 2 I pi fm minus f0 into t minus half into cos 2 I pi fm plus f0 into t. After passing through the low pass filter, high frequency term or cos 2 pi fm plus f0 into t will get eliminated and low frequency term or cos 2 pi fm minus f0 into t will get passed. So output of the low pass filter y2t is equal to half into cos 2 pi fm minus f0 into t. This signal is given as input to the balance modulator 4 along with the 90 degree shifted radio frequency carrier signal or c2 prime t. So the output of the balance modulator 4 will become v2t is equal to half into cos 2 pi fm minus f0 into t and sine 2 pi fcd. Now we will divide and multiply this equation by 2 or v2t will become v2t is equal to 1 by 4 into 2 into sine 2 pi fm minus f0 into t into sine 2 pi fcd. Now we can apply the formula of 2 sine a cos b is equal to sine a plus b plus sine a minus b. If we apply the formula in the equation of v2t, then the equation of v2t can be written as v2t is equal to 1 by 4 sine twice pi fc plus fm minus f0 into t plus sine twice pi fc minus fm plus f0 into t. This can be further simplified as v2t is equal to 1 by 4 sine twice pi fc plus fm minus f0 into t plus sine twice pi fc minus fm plus f0 into t. So we have generated the outputs of the balance modulator 3 and balance modulator 4. Now these two outputs of the balance modulator 3 and balance modulator 4 will be given as the input to the adder circuit, where these two signals will be added for the generation of the upper sideband SSBSC modulated signal and subtracted for the generation of the lower sideband SSBSC modulated signal. Now let's see how to generate upper sideband SSBSC modulated signal. For the generation of the upper sideband SSBSC modulated signal, the outputs of the balance modulator 3 and balance modulator 4 must be added together. So, upper sideband SSBSC modulated signal or S1T is equal to V1T plus V2T. And now, we can put the value of V1T and V2T from the previous equations. Then, upper sideband SSBSC modulated signal will result in this. If we simplify this, then S1T is equal to 1 by 4 into 2 into sine 2 pi fc minus f0 plus fm into t, which will result in half into sine 2 pi fc minus f0 plus fm into t. In this modulation, frequency of the audio frequency carrier signal or f0 is equal to fm by 2, where fm is the frequency of the message signal. If we put this value in the equation of s1t, then the upper sideband SSBSC modulated signal or s1t is equal to half into sine twice pi fc minus fm by 2 plus fm, which will be equal to half into sine twice pi fc plus fm by 2. So this is the equation of the upper sideband SSBSC modulated signal. For the lower sideband SSBSC modulated signal, we need to subtract the output of the balance modulator 4 from the output of the balance modulator 3. Then our s2t is equal to v2t minus v1t. After performing the simplification, s2t can be written as 1 by 4 into 2 into sine 2 pi fc plus f0 minus fm into t, which will result in half into sine 2 pi fc plus f0 minus fm into t. Again, the frequency of the audio frequency carrier signal, or F naught, is equal to FM by 2. And if we put this value in the equation of S2T, then the lower sideband SSBSC modulated signal, or S2T, is equal to half into sine twice pi plus FM by 2 minus FM, which will be equal to half into sine twice pi FC minus FM by 2. So this is the equation of the lower sideband SSBSC modulated signal. Let us see some advantages for the WebS method. In this method, suppression filters for any sideband are not required, and we also don't require wideband phase shifters. Here we have used the phase shifter for single frequency. That's why they are very simple and is inexpensive, and here there is no need for frequency adjustment. In this method, it is easy to change from upper sideband SSBSC to lower sideband SSBSC and vice versa. The disadvantage of this method includes: it is directly opposite of the filter method, but it is very complex. Commercially, it is very expensive and cannot be used for the regular purposes. This concludes our discussion for this lecture. In the event that you have any question regarding this presentation, feel free to post them in the comment section, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you in the next one.